Game theory started as a mathematical theory, a mathematical discipline studying games like chess or poker, because, you know, mathematicians, some of the Greek mathematicians like Borel and von Neumann were interested in applying mathematics to new fields. But it soon became clear that game theory can also be used to analyze social, market and political situations. Now, the big achievement of game theory was precisely to provide a mathematical language to do such an analysis. However, it didn't do so in a way that a normal person, the layman, so to speak, would expect it to do it. Because I think that a normal person would expect from game theory to be something that studies how players reason about each other, you know, how they put themselves in the shoes of one another. But game theory was not doing this actually at first. All this part was totally, you know, in the realm of informal interpretation. Instead, the contribution I'm talking about today is basically an expansion of the language of game theory that we call epistemic game theory, that analyzes in a formal mathematical way how players reason about each other and how they form their expectations about each other. In my work with Amanda Friedenberg and other scholars, what I do is precisely what the layman expects game theory to do. So I analyze formally, using mathematics, how players reason about each other. In particular, I do this in the context of sequential games, where players can make inferences about the motivation and goals of their co-players by observing their previous moves. And the theory that we formalize is that players rationalize moves by their opponents or co-players, assuming that their co-players are just trying to implement what is, from their point of view, their own best strategy. And this is called forward induction thinking. What we point out, however, is that forward induction thinking depends on the social context that shapes the shared beliefs. In particular, we point out that more restrictive social contexts that allow for a small variety of beliefs that player can hold give rise, counterintuitively, to weaker predictions about the reactions to unexpected moves. So this poses a problem because it is not enough to look at the most permissive social context to find robust prediction of forward induction thinking. And this is exactly the problem that we solve with our theoretical analysis.